Hey, what up, guys? It's Dahizzy here, aka Hassan the Assassin, giving gameplay commentary. Me playing some NBA 2K12 online ranked match with the Lakers versus the Miami Heat. And yes, the Lakers are my favorite team, so that's the reason why I'm using Lakers. But you know, I'll give it to Andrew Bynum in the paint and yam it on some guys. You know, yam it. And at the beginning of the game, we were close to each other. You know, we kept scoring on each other like for the very first 6 or 8 points or something. And yeah, it was basically like a seesaw. So, you know, I scored, he scored, and yeah. But that shot that you saw from Chris Bosh, that's some bull crap. Like, really? How you make a shot like that? He did, one of them Dirk Nowitzki fadeaways. And as you can tell, I scored my first 4 points in the paint. First four. So, you know what he does? He switches to a 2-3 zone. And I couldn't give it to my big man, whatever. You know, LeBron James, a left-hand hook shot, that's some bull crap, you know. LeBron James and the left hand don't mix, so why did he make it? But yeah, I couldn't score with anybody else besides Kobe Bryant, because I was trying to shoot some three-pointers, but no one would make threes. And I couldn't get rid of my big man, because there's too soft in the paint. So yeah, I had a sort of ball hog with Kobe. I'm sorry, guys, but he was using Miami Heat. I'm sorry. But, oh crap, man, I got that ADHD or something, man. I'm getting a little bit too distracted, and I'm not focusing on the commentary. But before I even talk about anything I really want to talk about, I would like to thank iPodKingCarter, aka Superman of YouTube, for giving me this opportunity to upload a video on his channel. I love you, bro. He's giving me a good chance for having exposure to my channel, you know, people checking out my channel and all that stuff. And I really appreciate it, so yeah. But anyway, what I really want to talk about is this quote. You know, you guys probably heard about it. It's hard work beats talent. Yeah, you guys probably heard it. It's very famous. People probably heard it from Kevin Durant, but it didn't really originate from Kevin Durant. I think it's Sam Lincoln or something like that. But yeah, you know, it's a very inspirational quote. You know, then there's a second part. I really didn't get it. It says when talent doesn't work hard. You know, when you bring all that together, it says hard work beats talent. When talent doesn't work hard, you know, the quote went from being very inspirational to a slap in the face. Like, what the hell? Like, there's another quote just like it. It's, if you first don't succeed, try again. First I heard this, I was like, I'm never gonna quit. Then I heard the second part. I heard it in elementary school, you know, very inspirational. I was like, yes, I'm never gonna quit again. And then I heard the second part because I looked it up on the internet, go on Google. It says, then quit. There's no point in being a damn fool about it. And I'm like, what the hell? So I believe in hard work beats talent, period. You know, I believe in the first. Oh, yeah, about this. This pissed me off right there. He showed a replay of him dunking. Like, really, you're about to lose, and you're gonna really do that. That's some bull crap. That's a bitch move. I was like, hell no. No, that pissed me off. So, yeah, basically, I'm going to win if you guys couldn't tell. And yeah, I really don't like that. He does it again, and that pissed me off, even though he was losing. So yeah. But yeah, back to what I was about to talk about. And yeah, I just believe in hard work beats talent, period. That's it, nothing else. And you guys are probably wondering, like, what if the talented person worked hard? And I'll just be like, really? Really? You know, being a straight face, pissed off face, and say, don't ask that ever again. The answer is simple, guys. Work harder than that talented person. Nothing to it. Really nothing to it. You know, you eventually surpass that person. It's going to take a little time. Just a little time. Maybe a lot of time. I'm just over-exaggerating things a little bit. And it's not going to be a microwave success, you know. You got to put some time and effort into things. And I'll give you an example. I just watched the last So You Think You Can Commentate video, right? As of right now. The guy had a speech impediment, and I looked at the comments, and I saw a lot of hate on this man, on this one person, especially on the way he talked. I'm thinking to myself, how the hell are you going to make fun of a person who has a speech impediment? The guy can't help it, really, really. So if I had cancer, or I was blind, would you make fun of me? If you do, that's a total bitch move right there. Like, what the hell? Like, that would piss me off. I hope the guy gets big on YouTube, because he isn't talented in the commentating area of life, you know, because of the way he talks. And, you know, people say he can't commentate on that bullcrap, but all you really need is a voice, you know, a voice to commentate. You know, you don't need any content out there, really. You know, you can have a black screen and you just talk. And, yeah, you know what I mean. But that's the one thing you gotta do, you know. You shouldn't listen to anybody, really. Anybody else. You know, the only person you should really listen to is yourself. That's it. Other people's opinions don't matter. People might tell you that you can't play basketball because you're too short. You can't play football because you're too small. Do you think Nate Robinson, Oral Boykin, Darren Sproles, Maurice Jones-Drew listen to any of those guys? Nah. They said, fuck off, y'all. Fuck off. All you haters out there. All you non-believers. You know, they said, I'm going to make it to the NBA, the NFL, to prove all you guys wrong. You guys aren't going to keep me down. Let's go with this. I don't know about you guys, but I have a dream. And the players that I mentioned, and maybe the guy with the speech impediment, have a dream as well. And in order to fulfill that dream, you have to work harder than anybody else. Everybody else, basically. And not listen to anybody. Besides yourself, because, you know, you got to listen to yourself. You know, keep yourself motivated. But, you know, my dream is to make the NBA. I'm 5'8". People might laugh at me, but they were probably laughing at Darren Sproles too. And, you know, look at where he is right now. You know, killing it in the NFL for the Saints right now. You know, killing it. And, you know, so basically what I'm trying to say is, if you want to live for a strong purpose in life, hard work isn't an option. It's a necessity. And, yeah, that's just my opinion, you know. I don't know. But, and yeah, that thing again, you know, with the bull crap, you know, showing the replay, and I'm just... What the hell? Really? You're losing. But, yeah. About that, I'm basically done with that commentary, you know. And what I want to talk about now is my content. My videos are based on what you have to do in order to see. You know, it motivates people, basically. It could be in video games, basketball, commentating, anything. They all require the same formula. My videos aren't all going to be serious. I might bring a little bit of humor. You know, I'm very sarcastic, so you might hear me say, I just got done eating some fried toenails or dolphin ankle or I don't know, something like that. And I'm probably going to teach all of you guys how to, in my videos, who watch my videos, how to get better in NBA 2K12, Call of Duty, and maybe FIFA, because I'm getting good in that. You know, getting good at that FIFA. And Gears of War, I can tell you how to suck at it, but that's basically it. I can tell you how to suck at Gears of War and nothing else, really, because I really suck at that game. And I'm probably the worst Gears of War player ever. And the only way I'll upload any Gears of War video, or actually I have already, but I'm not going to get into that, is if you want to see a bad Gears of War player, you know, die 20 bajillion times and stuff like that. But that's basically it. You know, and in the end of the game, you know, I just ripped him, you know, killed him basically. You know, Kobe for the two-pointer, you know, wets it up, you know, squashing it. And, you know, and purposely I made him shoot a three because, you know, I wanted to come back, you know, get all this excitement in him. And so, you know, I come up, you know, Kobe Bryant, you already know, clutch time, last 10 seconds basically. Dwayne Wade tried to say, oh, I can guard you. Oh, don't you remember December 4th? December 4th? Oh, no one can guard me. Get off me, Mario Chalmers. Mid-range? Do you know about my mid-range? And, you know, I said, Kobe Bryant said, I'm not going to guard anybody. But, you know, probably so I said, I got to rescue you. And, basically, I just won the game. And as you can tell by the stats, I was ball-hogging with Kobe. But I kept shooting. I tried to keep shooting with other people and stuff like that. But, you know, it's whatever. But, yeah, hope you guys like this gameplay commentary. And I want you guys to check out my channel. If you guys don't like my channel, you don't have to subscribe. Then you just leave or dislike all my videos. I don't care. But, yeah, just check out my channel if you want to. And, yeah, see you guys.